Hello. In this video, I will be discussing the surface integrals. Many of you are facing problems with surface integrals. So let's see what we can do with surface integrals. So we'll start with the basic concept what surface integrals are. As with line integrals, integrals over surface can involve vector and scalar fields and equally can result in either a vector or a scalar. The simplest case involves entirely scalars and it is of the form phi ds. So ds and phi were both may be scalars. So we may also encounter surface integrals involving vectors like phi ds, where phi is scalar and ds is a vector surface, a dot ds, where both a and ds are vectors, and a cross ds also, where both a and ds are vectors. So we'll briefly discuss the techniques to evaluate the surface integral over some surface. So let us start. So first, the most important part is we need to write the scalar area element ds in terms of coordinate differentials of our chosen coordinate systems. We'll illustrate it. So in some particular simple cases, it's very straightforward. For example, if S is the surface of a sphere of radius A, then using spherical polar coordinates phi, theta and phi on the sphere, we have ds summon a square sine theta d theta d phi. So this is a polar surface area in spherical polar coordinates. For a general surface, however, it is not usually possible to represent a surface in a simple way in any particular coordinate system. In such cases, it is usual to work in Cartesian coordinate and consider the projection of the surface onto the coordinate planes. So now we will see with the diagram. So consider a surface or part of surface as shown in the figure below. So this is the figure. So we will come into the figure. The surface S is projected onto a region R of the dx plane, so of the xy plane. So you see, this is my elemental surface area. My surface is a general surface like this. We will integrate the surface area over this xy plane. So for that, our projection will be like this. So whatever the angle is in between the surface and the projection is alpha. So you may should know that surface in general is a vector. So this ds vector surface area has a direction in this line, is the direction of the surface. This is tilted, this is not z line, this is not, the surface is not perpendicular over the xy plane, so there is a tilted angle. So the z angle surface, the z direction is along this, k direction is the direction of z axis and ds is the direction of the surface. So the angle is alpha between the k vector and the ds vector. So after seeing this, we see that ds equals to mod of cos alpha ds. Of course, this da, you see from the vector dot product rule that this da will be ds cos theta. Alpha is the angle between the unit vector k in the z direction and unit normal n to the surface at P. So this ds direction, this is the direction of unit normal. So this is the direction of your n cap. So at any given point of S, we have simply ds equals to da by mod of cos alpha. You see that your da is cos alpha ds, this da is cos alpha ds, and that's why ds is da by cos alpha. Look at again and you will understand. Then what cos alpha is? Cos alpha is the angle between these two directions, n cap and k. So your cos alpha, mod of cos alpha is n dot k. So this is a very simple vector rule. So if you don't know, you need to revise the basic vector concept first. So dot product of two vectors a dot b equals to mod of ab cos theta. So from there we will get this. So you have also seen that, so cos alpha equals to 1, sec alpha equals to 1 by cos alpha. So your sec alpha is 1 by n dot k. So now if the surface equation is given by f of xyz equals to 0, then the unit normal at any point of the surface is of course n cap equals to grad f by mod of grad f. This comes from the basic concept of gradient. So where it is can be proved that the direction of the unit normal is the gradient and make it unit vector. So grad f by mod of grad f is the direction of the unit normal of that surface. So the scalar element of surface area, which will become ds, dA by cos alpha, dA by n dot k. So ds equals to dA by n dot k. So this is n cap is grad f by mod of grad f. So this n dot k will be entirely grad f dA by grad f dot k. So this is a scalar, of course. So this is grad f dA by del f del z. How it becomes? So you should not miss that grad f dot k is, grad f is nothing but I del f del x plus j del f del y plus k del f del z. So dot k, which means del f del z. So your grad f dot k equals to del f del z. And you must remember that grad f and del f del z are evaluated on the surface S. So we can therefore express any surface integral over S as a double integral over R in the xy plane. And from here you also see that if we don't have any vector, we just evaluate the surface area, that dA will be sec alpha dx dy. Of course, your ds is dA by n dot k and n dot k equals to sec alpha. So if you are just evaluating the surface area, then your ds equals to dA by n dot k and this becomes sec alpha dx dy. You need to see the limits, you need to evaluate the limits on the surface in the xy plane. So now we will start with an example. So here our example is evaluate the surface integral I which is a dot ds, where a is a vector and ds is a vector surface, where a vector is just a very simple vector x I cap. So and s is the surface of the hemisphere. So this is a hemisphere x square plus y square plus z square plus a square with z greater equals to 0. The solution is, and the surface of the hemisphere is shown in the figure. So this is the hemisphere. We need to evaluate the vector integral, vector surface integral over that hemisphere. So this is your hemisphere. You just look at the figure. So this is the radius of the hemisphere is a. So that's why the limits are a. The surface in general, small, very small surface area is like this. And dA equals to dx dy, we need to evaluate the projection of that small surface area over that xy plane. So we'll evaluate in two ways. So very simply, ds, we know that this is in spherical polar coordinates, the hemisphere, we will take it in spherical polar coordinates. So the ds may be easily expressed in spherical polar coordinate as ds equals to a square sine theta d theta d phi, the simple polar surface area. And the unit normal to the surface at any point is simply r cap. Of course, this is r cap in any direction because this is a sphere. We can evaluate it by calculating the gradient also. On the surface of the hemisphere, we have x equals to a sine theta cos phi. Of course, this is on the surface of the hemisphere. So the x equals to r sine theta cos phi, general relation. So r equals to a on the surface, so x equals to a sine theta cos phi. And you also know that r cap unit vector is sine theta cos phi I cap plus sine theta sine phi j cap plus cos theta k cap. If you don't know all this, you need to go through the orthogonal cardinal coordinate system and the spherical polar coordinate system thoroughly in the vector calculus part. So what we get is a dot ds, a vector is what? X I cap. So a dot ds equals to x I dot r cap ds. So I dot r cap will be sine theta cos phi. So x is a sine theta cos phi, this is your x, and this I dot I cap dot R cap is nothing but sine theta cos phi, and ds equals to the surface element square sine theta d theta d phi. So this is a dot ds. The limit of a dot ds will be, of course, theta from 0 to pi by 2, not pi. If you go theta from 0 to pi, it will be the whole sphere, and the phi will be 0 to 2 pi. So you evaluate the limit, you get the answer 2 pi a cube by 3. I hope you understand this. Now we'll evaluate it in more formal way, what we have introduced just before. So the general prescription is just to project the hemisphere onto the region R. So this is the xy plane. So the general prescription will be, we'll project the hemisphere into the region R in the xy plane. So that a circle of radius A centered on the origin, of course this is the circle, this will become the circle if you project a hemisphere on the xy plane. So this is a circle. So the equation of the surface of the hemisphere, will write it as fxy equals to x square plus y square plus z square minus x square equals to 0, and using 3.7, what is 3.7? So 3.7 is that ds equals to dA by n dot k. We have just discussed all this, right, just little bit before. So grad f dA by grad f dot k, and we got grad f dA by del f del z. So we will just use this, and what we will get is a dot ds equals to x I cap dot r ds. So this is x I dot r cap, and ds all this project onto grad f dA by del f del z. So the grad f will be this 2x I cap 2 I j cap plus 2 z k cap equals to 2r. So on the surface we have grad f equals to 2a. Of course this is on the surface, so r equals to a, so grad f equals to 2a. Or more rigorously we can see that you put x equal values of x, y, z there. So or otherwise you get the mod grad f modulus, and then x square plus y square plus z square, that will square root, you will get a square. So modulus of grad f equals to 2a on the surface, and of course on the surface is del f del z equals to 2z. This is f, so your del f del z is 2z, which is we should not just leave it as z, because we will integrate on the surface where z equals to 0. So there will be a relation between x, y, z. So that is the equation of the hemisphere. So 2z equals to 2 square root of a square minus x square minus y square, and I dot r cap equals to x by a, we already know, right? So from where did you get it? We get it by just r equals to x I cap plus y z cap, x y I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. So the integral becomes I equals to r x square by square root of a square minus x square minus y square dx dy, this integral from here. So I guess you are understanding, right? DA is dx dy, and this x is x, I dot r I cap dot r cap is nothing but x by a, and this x square, this del f del z, we got it, del f del z is this, and grad f equals to 2a. So that's why this a and a cancels. So this integral you can evaluate it directly, but it is quicker to transform in plane polar coordinates. So I equals to r dash rho square cos square phi a square minus rho square. We are not in spherical polar, we are in cylindrical polar, just in xy we are transforming from xy to rho and phi. So this is rho square cos square phi a square minus rho square rho d rho d phi. So the limits are phi is 0 to 2 pi and rho is 0 to a. So evaluate the limits and we get just substitute, initially substitute in polar, then you substitute rho equals to some a sin u, and then calculate the integrals directly and you get the same answer. So you may ask that which procedure you should start for the general surface integral problems. My answer will be, initially you see that whether your surface is very symmetric or not. If the surface is a hemisphere kind of symmetric surface, you just start with this formalism. That will be easier. Otherwise, if your surface is some complicated surfaces, then you follow this general prescription and proceed accordingly. So this will be the end of my first video on surface integral. If you like it, of course I'll be posting more videos. So for today and for this video, it is over. Thank you very much for carefully listening the video.